Knowing the meaning of your surname and other surnames in your family tree gives you a wonderful glimpse into the past and can tell you something about your ancestors. While there are various ways of classifying surnames, broadly speaking, they fall into five main categories. These are parental, occupational, nickname, location, and feature of the landscape. The use of hereditary surnames was brought to Britain by the Normans, who'd already been using them for a couple of generations. Before this, people who had what we would think of as a surname didn't pass them down through the generations. They were known as bynames and could even change in a person's lifetime. Hereditary surnames were first used by the wealthy landowning families as a way of securing continuity of inheritance. The practice of using hereditary surnames then gradually filtered down to the rest of the population, starting earlier in the south and moving northwards, until by the 1500s it was becoming rarer not to have a surname. In Scotland and Wales, the picture is a bit different. In Scotland, clan names and local customs played a part. In Wales, the practice of using a single hereditary surname didn't start until later and was slow to be adopted widely. The most common surname in Britain is Smith and comes from the category of occupational names. In this case, an ancestor is most likely to have been the village blacksmith. This would have been a very important occupation in the village, just as the local baker, the cooper who made barrels, and the thatcher who repaired roofs would have been. While Smith may be the most common surname in Britain, many of the most frequent surnames come from a parent's name, usually the father. Your surname could be Thomas or Thompson, son of Thomas, or Married or Molson, both of which come from Mary. In Wales, their practice of using a father's name has led to surnames such as Jones, Williams, and Davies becoming among the most frequent surnames in Britain today. Two types of surname derive from a place where an ancestor may have lived. The first of these is from a specific location, such as a village, town, or estate. And the second is from a prominent feature of the landscape. Examples of well-known surnames that are based on location are Attenborough, Durham, and Thornton. And being named after a place was usually associated either with owning land there or having lived there and moving elsewhere. Surnames, such as Bridge or Bell, could indicate where your ancestor lived in the village or town, whereas living next to a natural feature could give you a surname such as Wood, Hill, or Brook. My favorite type of surname comes from a nickname because it can tell you something really personal about an individual. Brown is the most common surname of this type and is thought to come from a person's hair color or complexion, whereas Gifford is thought to come from fat cheeks. Newman is a surname that's thought to describe a newcomer to a town or village. One thing to remember is that your surname can have more than one origin. My surname King could come from someone who worked for the king, or as a nickname for someone who merely behaved as if he was one. So whatever your surname, Shepherd, Andrews, Eccleston, Orchard, or Swift, your surname contains within it a glimpse into the life of one of your ancestors.